everyone. Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another example of finding the area between two curves. In this particular example, we're given two functions. One is y equals x and the other is y equals x squared. The formula that we're going to be using to determine the area between these two curves is this formula here. Now, the first thing that you'll notice is that we have two functions here inside of our integral, f of x and g of x. One thing we're going to need to determine is which of our functions will be f of x and which one will be g of x, which we'll get to in a second. The other thing you'll notice about this formula is that we're going to be integrating on the range a to b. Now sometimes we're given our range or our limits of integration a and b. In this particular case we're not. So the first thing we have to do is find our limits of integration a and b. And the way that we're going to do that is by setting our two equations equal to one another. So we're going to set x equal to x squared, and we're going to solve this equation for x. So the way that we'll do that is subtract x from both sides to get this equation set equal to 0. Then we'll factor out an x on the right-hand side, and we'll end up with x times x minus 1. And what that tells us is that according to this term right here, x could be equal to 0, because right, if x were equal to 0, we'd have 0 out in front, it would we'd have 0 multiplied by this whole term, everything inside parentheses, and we'd get 0 equals 0, which would satisfy our equation. Or, according to this term, x could be equal to 1, because we'd get 1 minus 1 here, which would give us 0. We'd have this term multiplied by 0, and that would also satisfy the equation, which means that x is equal to either 0 or 1. So 0 and 1 are the points at which our two functions, y equals x and y equals x squared, intersect one another. So now that we've determined that, the next thing we need to determine is, like I said before, which of our functions will be f of x and which will be g of x. Now, when we're finding the area between curves, it's really important to figure out which is which, because f of x must be the function that is greater than or literally higher than the other function on the range at which we're evaluating. So in this case, 0 to 1. So if we look at a graph of these two functions, we can see the purple line here is y equals x. The orange curve is y equals x squared. And where they intersect one another here and here are at the points x equals 0 and 1, which we just determined are our two points of intersection where our functions are equal to one another. So you can see really easily that y equals x is above or greater than y equals x squared on this range. So two really easy ways to determine which one is higher: either graph it and you'll see right away, or you could pick any point in between our points of intersection. So since our points of intersection are 0 and 1, for example, you could pick 1/2, plug 1/2 into both functions, and whichever one is higher is your higher equation, and it's going to be f of x. So in our case, clearly we've seen that y equals x is greater than y equals x squared on the range 0 to 1, which means that our integral, we're going to plug in our limits of integration where our functions intersect one another, which we found to be 0 and 1. So we'll plug in 0 for a and 1 for b. We've determined that f of x is going to be equal to x here, because x is the function that's greater on the range 0 to 1. So we plug in x here for f of x, which means we're plugging in x squared for g of x. So we plug in x squared down here for g of x. Now to simplify this equation, or this integral, we just took away the parentheses here. We end up with x minus x squared. And this is simple enough to integrate right away. So what we're going to end up doing is integrating and then evaluating on the range 0 to 1. So to integrate, we'll take it term by term, looking at this x term here first. The exponent on this x term is 1. It's implied, we don't write it, but we have x to the 1 right here. We add 1 to the exponent when we integrate, so 1 plus 1 gives us 2. We divide the coefficient, which is also an implied 1, by the new exponent, 2, so we end up with 1/2 x squared. Same thing here, we add 1 to the exponent, so 2 plus 1 gives us 3. And then we divide our coefficient, which is 1, by the new exponent, 3. So this is the result after we integrate. And now we're going to evaluate on the range 0 to 1. So when we do that, we always plug in the top number first, in our case 1. So you can see we've plugged in 1 here for x. Then we always subtract in the middle and then plug in the bottom number, which in our case is 0. So we plug that in to our equation. Now we're going to simplify. So our first term here, 1 half times 1 squared is 1 half. 1 third times 1 cubed is 1 third, so we have a minus 1 third. And both of these terms are going to end up being 0, so we end up with a minus 0 plus 0 because we have a double negative here, but it doesn't really matter because it's just 0. So that leaves us with 1 half minus 1 third. If we find the lowest common denominator, which is 6, and we modify here our fractions, we'll end up with 3 sixths minus 2 over 6. And when we simplify, you can see that our final answer is going to be 1 sixth. So 1 sixth is the area between those two curves on the range 0 to 1. And that's it. That's our final answer. So I hope that helps you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!